Hello everyone, and welcome to a new IBM RPG sample video. Today we're going to talk about a very interesting topic, sensitive and insensitive cursors when using embedded SQL inside RPG. I will explain what they are, how they behave, and we'll also see some practical RPG code examples. Let's go! In embedded SQL, a cursor is like a pointer that lets us move through the rows returned by a select query. When we open a cursor, the system creates a result set, and they can fetch rows one by one. But what happens if someone updates the table while we are still processing the cursor? This is where sensitive and insensitive cursors come into play. What is an insensitive cursor? Well, an insensitive cursor behaves like this. Give me a snapshot of the data as it is right now, and don't worry about any changes that happen later. Well, once a cursor is open, it doesn't see any inserts, updates, or deletes that happen afterwards. It is like taking a photo of the data at that exact moment. The advantages of this are that we're gonna have a faster performance because the result set is already built, and we don't need to worry about data changing while you are processing, okay? Of course, we have disadvantages in this case, the odd that we are not seeing the real-time updates, okay? In the other hand, we have the sensitive cursors. A sensitive cursor behave like this. Show me the data right now, and if it changes while I'm processing, I want to see the changes too. As you fetch rows, if another job updates a record that matches your result set, you will see the updated value when you fetch it. If a row is deleted before you fetch it, you might get an error or simply not see it. What are the advantages? The advantages in this case? Well, you are going to work always with fresh data, okay? And the disadvantages are that we are going to have a slower queries because the database has to keep checking for changes, okay? And this is going to be more complex to handle. In a real world example, we can say that this is something like, imagine walking into a store and picking items from the shelf one by one. If someone changes a product while you are shopping, you immediately see the new version, okay? Well, there's also a third option, that is the ASENSITIVE cursors, okay? The ASENSITIVE cursors tell the database, you decide if you should behave like sensitive or insensitive. If you don't specify anything, the default is ASENSITIVE. So, for example, let me open here. Okay, imagine that we are declaring a cursor. Let me make it bigger. Something like this. Okay, this is a simple cursor, and we are opening it for reading all the this table, customers table, okay? Well, if you are not specifying anything else, the system treats it as ASENSITIVE. The pros in this case are that the database optimizer picks the most efficient behavior, okay? This is often faster, okay? The cons are that you are losing the control, and you might sometimes see the changes and sometimes not. It depends, okay? In a real-world example, we can say that this is like if you are going to a restaurant and you are telling the chef, surprise me, okay? You trust them, but you don't have the control, okay? So if you need a specific behavior, then it is better to explicitly declare sensitive or insensitive, okay? Well, you can use sensitive, insensitive, or asensitive with both normal cursors and scroll cursors, okay? Well, as you know, scroll cursors are the same as normal cursor, but you can control how you move inside the result set. Okay, you can go next, prior, first, last, absolute. Okay, sensitivity controls whether you see changes or not. There are two separate things. You can combine them however you like. Okay, you can, for example, declare a cursor as this, scroll insensitive cursor for the rest. Okay, you can write here sensitive cursor, or you can write here asensitive cursor or asensitive scroll cursor. Okay, you can do whatever you need, all is valid. Well, for making an example, we're gonna create some tables to practice. Okay, let me copy the declaration that we have, that I have in another screen. Okay, we're gonna have two tables, the customers table, okay, that is gonna have these three fields. Okay, and this is gonna be the orders table. Okay, we are using in this case referential integrity because customer ID is a foreign key in orders. Okay, if you don't want to use commit and rollback, you can set your job to known commit control or use commit known in your connection, but be careful if you are inserting or updating data manually. Okay, well, let me also add some data to my tables. We are gonna have three customers and also we are gonna have three orders. Okay, okay, we have all this data in customers and in orders, we have all this data. Okay, well, we're gonna make a first example in RPGLE. Let me create a new program here. Okay, let me write simple program. Okay, in this case I'm gonna have a customer ID, also I'm going to have a customer name, and also customer email. Okay, let me declare a cursor that is gonna be an insensitive cursor for this select customer ID, customer name, and customer email from customers. Okay, I'm gonna open the cursor and also I'm going to close it. Okay, and I'm going to go through the cursor with a loop. So I'm going to fetch next from C1 into customer ID, customer name, and customer email. Okay, and if SQL code is equal to 0. I'm going to send a message to the job log with customer ID customer name, for example. Very simple, okay? Let me compile this program. Okay, and it is compiled. Okay, basically, notice that we are declaring it as insensitive cursor. Okay, so we are working with a snapshot of the database. So imagine that we have this program that is reading a lot of rows, and between the first fetch and the last fetch, maybe there are many new customers that are being added to our database, or many customers that have been changed their email or something. Okay, well, we are not going to get that information. We are going to read only what it is in the database when we are declaring the cursor. Okay, well, let me run the program as an example to see the result. Test. Okay, run action and call the program, and this is what I'm getting. Okay, customer 1, customer 2, customer 3 with the names, okay, as it were declared before. Great. Well, imagine that we want this cursor, but we want a sensitive cursor in this case. Okay, well, in that case, we have to change it a little. Okay, let me create a different example. Let's work now with the orders ID, with the orders table. Okay. Oops. Okay, we are going to declare a sensitive scroll cursor in this case. Okay. Select order ID, order amount. Orders, and we are going to update information. Okay, for update of order amount. Okay, we're going to update the cursor. Okay, open and close. Let's create a loop as before. And we're going to fetch next from C2 into order ID, order amount. Okay, well, and if SQL code is different than is equal to 0, then what we are going to do in this case is send a message up, dating order plus order ID. Now the order amount is gonna be, for example, plus 10, and we are going to update the information. Update orders set order amount is equal to order amount where current of C2. okay In this example, we have declared it sensitive and used for update of and where current of to update directly through the cursor. Okay. Well, so in this video, we have been talking about sensitive, insensitive, and asensitive cursors, understanding how they behave, their pros and their cons, how to use them with normal and scroll cursors, and we have also seen some practical RPG examples. I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.